Everybody, it's Jamie from Old Shipping Lines and welcome back to a new video. Now in the video of today, we shall talk about the tragic sinking of the SS Pendleton. Now you might know her as she was the T2 tanker in the movie The Finest Hours. In this video, we shall talk about her whole life. Now, the ship was built for the United States Maritime Commission. And she was built by the shipbuilders Kaiser Shipyards in Portland, Oregon, in the United States. Now, if we talk about her specifics, the gross tonnage of this vessel would be 10.448 gross registered tons, with her length being 504 feet 0 inches, and she had a beam of 68 feet 2 inches. Her propulsion was turboelectric, a steam turbine driving a generator that produced electricity to power a motor that drove the propeller shaft. She could go a speed of 16 knots. She would be launched on January the 21st, 1944, and she would be completed in February 1944. Now, like I said earlier, she would be built for the United States Maritime Commission, but she was owned by the Warshipping Administration. Her port of registry was Portland, Oregon. Pendleton served as a member of convoy ON-249 during World War II. The convoy set sail from Liverpool on August the 18th, 1944. And reached New York on September the 2nd. Now, after the war, the Pendleton was transferred to National Bulk Carriers located in Willington, Delaware by 1948. However, in July 1951, the Pendleton ran aground in the Hudson River in New York, but she was refloated the following day. Now, the damaged part of the hull, keep this in mind, would later play a key role in the sinking. On February the 18th, 1952, while en route from New Orleans to Boston, the Pendleton broke in two in a gale south of Cape Cod, Massachusetts. Now, the section where she broke up was the same section where she was damaged after she ran aground in 1951. Now, if we take a moment, think how terrifying it must have been for the crew. Because when a ship breaks in two, you hear that, you feel that. It must have been terrifying. A consolidated PBY Catalina airplane of the United States Coast Guard was retasked from its search for the Ford Mercer T2 tanker to look for the Pendleton, and successfully located both parts. It was at this moment that the Coast Guard became aware that there were two separate vessels that had split into two pieces. The Coast Guard motor lifeboat CG-36-500, captained by Boatswain's Mate First Class Bernard Weber, was dispatched by Commanding Officer Daniel Webster Clough from the USCG station at Chatham, Massachusetts. Despite being pounded by waves while crossing the sandbar out of the harbor, the Coast Guard motor lifeboat persevered and located the stern section of the Pendleton. Unfortunately, the boat sustained damage and lost its compass during the rough journey, going on to perform a daring rescue of her crew. With precision, Weber navigated the motor lifeboat beneath the tilting hull and skillfully guided the Coast Guard vessel through the rolling waves. Meanwhile, the crew of the Pendleton descended down the side using a Jacob's ladder, timing their descent to the rhythm of the ocean's rise and fall. They leaped from the swaying ladder onto the deck of the motor lifeboat, which was in motion due to Weber's careful maneuvering. He kept his boat positioned under the ladder, but also made sure to steer clear of the towering hull of the broken-up Pendleton. 8 of Pendleton's 41 crew members were lost, including Captain John Fitzgerald, who were on the bow section. The bow section hadn't been part of the rescue. Amid the chaos of their vessel's struggle against strong gale force winds, the ship's cook from the stern section exhibited selflessness. He aided his crewmates in evacuating the ship before he himself attempted to disembark. Tragically, as the ship began to drift off a sandbar where she had briefly become grounded, the cook leaped from the Jacob's ladder into the churning waters below and was struck by the Pendleton as she was hit by a wave, killing him instantly. 1 week later, after her grounding, Pendleton's bow was boarded. Sadly, out of the 8 victims stranded on that section, only one corpse, frozen, was retrieved. The survivors were successfully brought to safety at Chatham. The daring rescue of the survivors of the Pendleton is regarded as one of the United States Coast Guard's most courageous rescues. All 4 crew members of the motor lifeboat received the Coast Guard's Gold Lifesaving Medal as a result. Now, like I said in the intro, the Pendleton was the T2 tanker in the movie The Finest Hours, which released in 2016. The movie is about this tragedy and this daring rescue, and is one of my favorite movies. I highly recommend you watch it.
And that is the end to a video. Thank you all so very much for watching. I appreciate the support. If you liked this video, please consider subscribing to the channel. That would help out the channel a lot. And don't forget to click on the video suggested here in the outro, as I'm sure you will enjoy that one as well. Now, if you have any comments or thoughts on this video, please leave them in the comment section down below. As well, what ships you would like me to cover next. Now, with that out of the way, guys, I wish you all a good night or day, wherever you are, and we will see each other on the next video. Goodbye, my friends.